It's cold weather, man. We ain't got nothing else to pick and harvest.
Yeah, I mean, everything's gone.
We'll just go back to the damn old-timers' way. Take some damn birch bark liquor.
250 miles southwest in Sevier County, Tennessee, Mike and Jerry look to the forest for a low-cost ingredient that produces high-quality shine.
Jerry, what we're looking for is a black birch. It's wintertime, and there's nothing else to really pick and harvest out here in the woods, you know. But we've got to come up with something to minimize our cost for people to buy our product for a smaller price. So why not just go back to a traditional thing to do, birch bark whiskey? See this one right here? Peel that bark. Tell me what you think on that one.
Oh, my God.
You tell that damn smell.
Son, that's good enough to eat right there.
I told you, you'd know it when you walked up on it.
I could have put that in my mouth like a piece of chewing gum.
You can chew it. That's going to make some damn good liquor right there.
You just would not believe the flavor that's packed in that little limb. It's almost like a root beer barrel candy or a sassafras.
Ha-ha, good boy. Well, we got our birchies, boy. Let's go get the bark off of it.
Yeah, get her stripped down.
A little stripping? Hell yeah, baby. We're not going to chip anything up. We're not going to use the whole log. You know, we're just stripping the bark off. The sap that's in it, that's where your flavor is at, in between the meat of the tree and the outer layer of the bark, that dark, dark, dark brown looking stuff. That's where all the flavor is. And we cook that out and extract that out into that water. Are you ready to get some damn skinning on?
You kill me. I'm about to be using to make furniture out of it when we get done.
Shouldn't be too hard to skin a damn log, should it? That right there, see that little dark stuff?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, smell of that.
It's kind of hard for me to smell it, and I got it in my mouth. It's all about finding a rhythm, isn't it?
Yep, find your rhythm. The only downside of this man is being humped over where we are.
Ever heard of the humpback in Notre Dame?
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to be down these days over here.
I'm telling you. Them old-timers had it rough, didn't they? Doing this to every log, every board to build houses with and stuff.
I'm gonna tell you what, son, a kid of this day and age come up doing this stuff right here.
Yeah, they'd be different people, wouldn't they?
They'd die, yeah. If ain't some heritage this right here, there ain't nothing gonna be.
That's right. Woo! Doo-doo-doo-doo. That's a pretty log you got there.
Well, thank you, Mike.
Shut up. Damn, I put my foot in my mouth every time I say something, don't I?
The smell coming off this is just absolutely incredible. Makes me just want to be like a beaver and just eat me a big old chunk of this wood off.
God almighty, boy. I'm going to tell you, Jerry, I won't be scared to say this might be our best run of the damn year right here if it turns out. As far as a flavor profile, this is going to be damn good. We got plenty enough to make 3 barrels, don't we?
Sure do.
Well, birch bark, it packs a lot of flavor in it. I'm going to go ahead and go add some water in on this and cap it. We want to keep that flavor. That's why we're soaking it overnight in water to keep it from drying out until we can reach the point of getting it mashed in. But we've got 3 5-gallon buckets. Get back in here tomorrow and mash this stuff in and save all the flavor we can and potentially have a good liquor. Woo! I know one thing. We need to do that kind of stuff more often. My damn arms feel like damn spaghetti noodles. Oh, man, that is some good smelling stuff. Me and Jerry, we fixed to get this birch bark mashed in. We've let it set overnight. It's been soaking in its water and keeping all the saps in where it won't dry out. So all we got to do is mash this stuff in and get it ready to go. I'll go ahead and just dump one of my buckets of birch bark in this pot. That water saved it. Look how pretty and dark that water is off that birch bark. You can mash that water right there and have good birch bark whiskey. But we're going to pump it up, make it right, and make it good. The first thing I've got to do here is boil all this down and get all that good sweet sap out of here, and then lay the sugar, water, and yeast to it. We'll have birch bark mash. I tell you what, Jerry, since I got this part here done, I'm gonna sit here and watch this come to a boil. If you'll go up there to the truck, get the rest of that sugar off the truck for me.
I can do that.
Appreciate you, buddy.
I guess I'm got to pick up your slack anyway, huh?
You might as well. I've been toting your ass all season long.
Oh, okay.
Old Jerry, I don't know what I'd do without that boy. He's a damn good helper, man. A good partner.
You know something amazes the hell out of me?
What's that?
Last season, we built a staircase with 100 steps in it, and we can't even build a 10-foot staircase this year.
I know. That's some good stuff, ain't it?
You ain't kidding. Put a little sugar on that?
Yeah, buddy. You wait till it comes to a rolling boil when it starts cooking all of it out there. It'll be right.
Wow, what a flavor. Getting excited about this run, man.
Oh, hell yeah.
Seems like everything we've been doing here lately, just a little bit newer, a little bit different stuff.
Yep. And the good part about it, so far, everything's actually come together pretty good for us.
Yeah.
It's sure different, you know. This is an old-timer recipe here. There ain't a lot of people do this no more.
And there might be some of the generation, you know, that grew up, you know, their grandpas and stuff doing it. And
right.
We'd like to have a jar or two just for good sentimental purposes anyway. Man, crack a jar open with that right there and smell of it. It's going to be like...
take him back to his damn childhood, oh, yeah. Won't it?
Even if it was a candy or a chewing gum or any of that kind of
that's
stuff.
That's right.
It'll still take him back.
It sure will. Once we boil all the birch bark down, if you'll notice that water, that tea, is just brown. That's where all the flavor is. Look at that damn water right there.
Looks like a good old southern sweet tea, don't it?
It does. That's like sweet tea. Got the smell to it, don't it?
Hell yeah, it does.
That's gonna be some good stuff, buddy.
The water's up to temperature, it's starting to boil on us, and man, the aroma coming off there. It's like a good root beer candy or a piece of sassafras. It's just amazing. It's like grandma's green beans cooking on the stove.
You know what, Jerry, I'm thinking a little bit on this.
Oh, yeah?
We want to keep all the flavor and everything that we possibly can.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm not worried so much about a real damn high proof. So I figured, why don't we cut back on our sugar just a little bit? Say maybe go to 3 bags instead of 4 bags a barrel?
Yeah, that wouldn't be bad. We don't really want to over-alcohol this stuff because we want the flavor, the taste profile is what we're really after. So we're going to back it down to 3 bags of sugar instead of 4.
You know, when we modify that still down to run this, I want a good... tasteful liquor that people know exactly where it come from is that birch bark. You know,
they can taste nature in it.
We're doing right the opposite. We're not making a vodka here. We're making a whiskey.
Oh yeah.
You know, we're making something somebody can drink and have the flavor all in the drink itself. Oh,
yeah. You know, I think with a drink like this right here too, I mean, they're gonna want it because it's gonna be something unique. They're gonna want it for that flavor.
Exactly.
So I mean, we don't have to have it just, you know, over an abundance and high proof.
No, absolutely not. Give somebody something they can enjoy.
Yeah.
Well, birch bark is a pretty strong bark. It packs a lot of flavor in it. Looky there, looky there. Well, it roughly takes about a half to 3/4 of a 5-gallon bucket of bark for 1 50-gallon barrel of mash. But that's all it takes to get that flavor. You don't want to overdo it and that be all you taste and it's you want to spit it out. You got to find that happy medium. That's what all the old timers told me to do, and that's the approach that I'm taking, and hope and pray it turns out right. Damn, it is hot, ain't it? All right, buddy. Round 3.
You know, now that we got all 3 of these barrels mashed in, man, it's smelling amazing. We're going to get this thing packed back up with hay, get her covered up, keep all the moisture and stuff off of it, and let this stuff rock and roll.
You know? That went good, didn't it, brother?
Man, I tell you what, I think it's going to make some fine liquor right there.
Me and you both, buddy.